This is CBS 2 News at 11. Now, from Studio 46.
Dana, now to an important development about 9/11. New York City's health department is releasing long-awaited instructions for treating 9/11-related illnesses. CBS 2's Brendan Keefe, live in Lower Manhattan, with the guidelines, some of which are alarming. Brendan?
Jim, what's most alarming is what's not in the guidelines. There's no mention of cancer, leukemia, or other serious illnesses reported by thousands of people who were told it was safe to come back.
The dust settled 5 years ago, but the controversy over the toxic effects of September 11th is just getting started.
55 of my clients have died of causes that on their death certificate are clearly related.
Attorney David Warby represents 8,000 World Trade Center survivors and first responders with various ailments that could fill a medical textbook. He says the health department's new guidelines vastly underestimate the crisis.
It's garbage. They don't even talk about asbestosis and mesothelioma. There was 400,000 pounds of asbestos that burned there for 4 months that people breathed into their lungs. This is not just a respiratory cough problem. This is a cancer problem.
Cancer is not mentioned in the new 9/11 report. The health department tells doctors to look only for these symptoms: sinus congestion, heartburn, wheezing and coughing, and psychological depression.
They're more worried about people committing suicide than they are people dying from leukemia.
The health department is in a difficult situation. Its primary responsibility is to protect the health of its citizens, but it's also a city agency, and therefore anything it puts in writing could be used against the city, potentially in thousands of lawsuits. We're live in Lower Manhattan. Brendan Keefe, CBS 2 News.